My name is Ryan Jackson. I'm a postdoc. I'm here at Montana State University in the Wiedenheft Lab. What my strengths are is structural biology. So I try to figure out what really small things look like. So small that we can't see those things with microscopes. Thus, we have to do what's called crystallography. We have to crystallize these small molecules or proteins. Before we get to this step, what you need to do is actually purify it, the molecule that you want to crystallize. And it has to be super pure. And that's what we use the other lab to do, is purify a protein that we want to crystallize. We actually have a robot. Would you like to see the robot?
Yeah.
It's pretty cool. And the nice thing about this robot is allows you to screen a lot of different conditions at a time. We have to screen upwards of 5,000 conditions before we find the condition that the protein will crystallize in. Then what I'm showing you here is we do produce crystals, but they're really small. They're not like the rocks you find in your backyard, but these are very, very small protein crystals. And so you actually have to use a microscope just to see the crystals. Once we've crystallized them, we shoot x-rays at them. We get a really cool diffraction pattern, very similar to like when you shine a light on a prism, you get the rainbow. When you do this with x-rays, you get a very symmetrical spot pattern. It's pretty cool, huh? Why would we want to do this? Well, it's because if you know what something looks like, then you can figure out how it works. And so the molecules that I study are usually the ones that are running the show when it comes to life. They're the molecules important for cellular processes. Specifically, we look at molecules that like to bind to DNA. And that's important if you want to fix DNA or if you want to change DNA. I grew up in a small town called Mendon, Utah. It sits at the base of some pretty steep mountains. My mom is an English teacher, so she likes to read. She's reading a book a week. She definitely instilled that love of learning in us. My dad is an engineer. He worked for a company that made the rocket boosters that launched the space shuttle up into space. And so neither my mom or my dad is really using the scientific method, but I kind of was using the scientific method growing up all the time. I like to look at ants. I was a bird watcher. I definitely like to observe wildlife. And when I started college, I didn't know what I was going to major in. I really enjoyed teaching, and so I thought I was going to be a high school teacher of science. And I started taking courses that put me in that direction, and I also took another class called immunology. So I was sitting in this class, and my teacher was telling us about how antibodies work, and I realized that he wasn't telling me the full story. So I went up to him after class and said, "Hey, what's going on? Like, how did they figure this stuff out?" And he smiled really big at me and he said, "Why don't you come volunteer to work in my lab? Why don't you come see what we're doing upstairs? We're trying to find answers to big questions. We try to figure out how bacteria defend themselves against viruses." And that's it, fun for people to actually wrap their head around. What, bacteria get sick? We use a lot of techniques to do that.
Each one of those little colors is an atom.
I definitely, my sights are on becoming a professor. I think it's the perfect job for me because I really do enjoy watching people learn something new.
And then there's the other option, is if you can check the toxins.
It's awesome to see the light go on. And when I've had that experience, it was really fun. So I actually enjoy being the catalyst of that happening. We live here in Montana, and you know, Lewis and Clark came through here at one point to discover what was here. And basic research is the opportunity to continue that discovery process. We see new things that no one else has seen. This is actually a really cool process. You can maybe hear a little bit of a hum in the background. It's a ring of copper that's spinning really, really fast. There's electrons of the copper. They absorb the energy from the electricity. They bounce up, and then when they fall back down, they emit an x-ray. And so this is all controlled by the computer, which is right over here. So when we shoot x-rays at the crystal, you get a what we call spot pattern, or these are reflections. The coolest thing about this, really, this is the exact same method that Rosalind Franklin used to figure out the structure of DNA. Your small discovery may change the world. Our specific field 10 years ago was just simple basic research. What does this thing do? And now the application of this field is possibly going to cure genetic diseases. If no one looked, we'd still be where we were 10 years ago, but that's just the reason why. It's really fun to be at the cutting edge of knowledge. That's why you would do this, is that you want to learn and do things that other people in the world have never done before.
So this here is a three-dimensional map of what's in that crystal.
And then there is also this opportunity that once you've learned those things, you can then teach other people. If you enjoy that type of thing, then this is the job for you.